This is a microbe that lives in your gut. Can you guess how many microbes live inside of your digestive system?
100,000?
Nope, not even close. There are 40 trillion microbes that live in your gut. 40 trillion. That means that if you spend 1 second counting each of them, you would be counting for 1,268,391 years. Isn't that crazy? This is Quick Q. If you have a science or tech question, your chem guides are here to answer it. I am Ana Maria Porras. I am a biomedical engineer, and I will be your chem guide today.
What does a biomedical engineer do?
A biomedical engineer is a person who solves problems related to human health and human medicine. So we do things like design better x-ray machines, design an artificial or metal leg or arm, or if you're like me, you decide to just study biology and figure out how the human body works. So I study the gut microbiome of different people around the world. And today we're gonna talk about the creepy crawlies or microbes that live inside of your gut.
What's the difference between microbes and a microbiome?
This is a microbe and this is a microbiome. A microbiome is a collection of microbes that all live together in one environment. So for example, all of the microbes that live in our intestines make up our gut microbiome.
What are those?
These are microbes that I crochet myself. I started crocheting 5 years ago because it was too cold where I lived and I needed to make myself new hats and scarves. One day I decided to make some of the microbes that I study in the lab and I posted them on Instagram. And from then it took off and I decided to start doing it every Monday. And so you can find new microbes and learn about them every hashtag Microbe Monday. Microbes are really, really tiny and we cannot see them with the naked eye. This is an image that has been taken with a microscope. So I take a look at those images and then I decide how to make them. In our gut, we have microbes in a bunch of different shapes. And this is just one example. Microbes that are shaped like this, like a rod, are often called bacillus. This is a coccus bacteria. So bacteria that are shaped like a sphere, like a coconut, are called coccus, which is a word in Latin that means round.
What's your favorite one?
This is my favorite microbe. It's not actually a microbe. It's a type of mushroom. It's called fly amanita. Actually, if you look up mushroom in your phone when you try to use an emoji, you'll see one of these.
Wow, so cute.
That's enough about my favorite microbes. Let's get into your real science cues.
When did your passion for science begin?
I think I was always curious, and my parents are actually engineers, so we were exposed to science and encouraged to ask questions from a really early age. I remember when I was little, I wanted to be a marine biologist, until one day I remembered that marine biologists have to swim with sharks, and then I decided that was not a good idea.
Are microbes only in our gut?
They are everywhere in our body, on our skin, on our hands, on our feet, even inside our mouth. You can find them also in your pets, as well as everywhere in the environment. They're everywhere within and around us, and actually without them, our planet and ourselves, we wouldn't survive for very long.
So how do you have healthy gut microbes?
You can actually more or less control what microbes are in your gut depending on what you eat. So if you want to keep your gut microbiome healthy, eat a lot of different types of fruit and veggies. In Colombia, we eat a lot of beans. Beans are good for you. They have a lot of fiber. In Korea, people eat kimchi, which is a fermented food that's also good for you.
What interested you into studying the gut microbiome?
What I like about it is that everyone has their own personal gut microbiome. So I am really interested in understanding how it is that gut microbiomes change in different people around the world. Dream big, and when I was little growing up in Colombia, I didn't even know that biomedical engineering existed. But I knew that I really liked engineering and that I really liked biology. So as long as you stay curious, you can discover or even create your own career. Check out GoldieBlox.com where you can find all sorts of fun activities like how to make your own crocheted microbe. Click the link in the description below to watch cool tools and learn how to track orcas with your guide, Gracie, and learn how to code. Don't forget to stay curious, fellow campers. A huge thank you to the Lyda Hill Philanthropies for making this episode possible.